15 most abandoned aircrafts were cannot looked away from all over the world.
Airplanes have been abandoned in some of the strangest and most beautiful places. Most of us as children had a fascination with airplanes and things that flew way up in the sky. For some, the fascination never ends even when they grow. It turns into passion, a hobby, and sometimes even phobia. We have to admit, there is something undeniably empowering about airplanes, for they let us wingless folk reach heights and we were never evaluation ready for. And then, there is the ease of transport that comes with airplanes. They have made the world way smaller than what it was before. Here the airplanes rust in peace, till they are dismantled into nothingness, as if they never really were.
These 15 most beautiful abandoned airplanes that stay with us is a reminder of how time changes all for everything.
The curious case of the Bali Boeing. To the south of the Bukit Peninsula in Bali, you can spot a very well-preserved Boeing 737, just lying about in an open field next to what used to be a limestone quarry. No one knew how it got there, and who brought it, and most important, why it was brought to the place where no airplanes should be at. It is right next to the Raya Nusa Dua Selatan Road, 5 minutes from the very popular Pandawa Beach, so it's not exactly hidden from the world. Most believe it was brought there to be turned into a restaurant, but the owner ran out of investment, and so just dumped the plane and the idea and moved on. They grounded forever, keybird. The picture is misleading. This was how the plane looked before an attempt rescue mission. It was documented in a Nova episode, B-29, Frozen in Time. This particular keybird was a US Air Force commissioned Boeing B-29 Superfortress of the 46th Reconnaissance Squadron and was flying a secret mission during the Cold War. It was supposed to be flying to Greenland and back when the pilot got disoriented and changed directions, finally making an emergency landing on a frozen lake in northwest Greenland on February 21, 1947. In 1994, a privately funded mission tried to rescue it but ended up destroying the wreckage when a fire spread. The plane still lies where it landed, but now in burned tatters. Abandoned might. The military might have forgotten the old and faithful bird that led to great victories, but that doesn't mean they will let anyone disturb the haunting resting places of the decommissioned airplanes. Some aircraft crushed in remote and far-flung areas where they could never be recovered. A few, such Douglas DC-3, reached an abandoned and rather haunted place in Croatia, where trespassers are warned off with the presence of landmines. The people who took this picture apparently asked a few local children to lead them to this place on the pretext of finding sweets. And one child did step on a mine and get badly hurt. Is the picture worth the trauma? You decide. The remains of a rather infamous aircraft. The skeletal remains in this picture belong to the Fairchild C-123 provider plane, best known as the transporter plane in the Nicolas Cage and John Travolta starring Con Air. However, that's not the reason for this particular carrier's infamousness. This was the plane used by special forces to spray Agent Orange on acreage upon acreage of Vietnam's forests, and to a lesser extent in Laos and Cambodia as well. This particular herbicide was a defoliant. The idea was to raise the forest the Viet Cong were hiding in. Sadly for the millions of Vietnamese exposed to these dioxin-containing chemicals. The ramifications were far worse. The Red Cross estimates that more than 1 million people have major health problems due to exposure and the continuing genetic damage as critical. A machine now part of the stark landscape. How long does a thing need to lie before it eventually becomes a part of the surroundings? In the case of this ghostly wreckage, it's a good number of years of wasting away in the harsh African desert, before even the desert fauna adapts to it. Whether this plane made an emergency landing here or crashed, no one knows. It lies in the middle of nowhere with no human contact at all. Just the sun and the sand keep it abrasive company. The sand itself seems to have accepted it, now conforming to the shape of the fuselage itself. It lies as a testament to the human spirit that is both strength and weakness at the same time. Beechcraft Model 18. The Beechcraft C-18 was a popular small plane in its heydays, continuously produced from 1937 to 1969. Since it was in production for more than 32 years, it set a world record at the time. Some 9,000 of these made and used as civilian and military aircraft for cargo, utility, and passenger purpose. They could be nose-wheeled, tail-wheeled, and even operated on skis and floats. This particular plane has been languishing in a rural airport hangar in New Hampshire, and the backstory remains hidden. The whys and where forces apart. Some 240 of these are still in the commission, which also makes it a rather hardly plane to have existed this long. Abandoned Boeing House. Abandoned planes the world over can look at this example in hope, if they were sentient beings. A man named Bruce Campbell bought a retired Boeing 727's fuselage and installed it in a 10-acre suburban land he owns just outside of Portland, Oregon. He then set about converting it into a home after propping it up on concrete pillars replete with a driveway. He has converted quite a bit of inside into a real home, and the aircraft has a makeshift shower as well. Though he's still working on installing a working lavatory and some of the airplane's original lights. He spent about $23,000 on the land purchase, but the fixer-upping on the plane has cost him another $220,000 already. The photo above is of a similar project at the Hotel Costa Verde and is a tourist attraction. Abandoned in Bangkok. Away from the international airport in Bangkok is a field enclosed within tall buildings and a school on one side. Within this habitat lie Bangkok's discredited and decommissioned planes, stripped of all that is value and waiting to be turned into scrap metal. Most of the planes are Boeing 727s, erstwhile passenger planes that are now being used by Bangkok's homeless as a shelter till the time the authorities approved them. The last we know of, these squatters charge a fee from the tourists who want to come and explore these for God-saken planes, and they are poor enough to warrant it. The black-sanded crash site in Iceland. The Solheimasandur airplane wreckage is a rather famous one and a vividly photographed one that, while the plane looks badly damaged, all passengers survived this crash. That's making it a rather unearthly sight, but not a haunting one. It's located on Iceland, southernmost coast between Skógafoss waterfall and the town of Vík. To get to it, you need to drive past Skógafoss going east on Route 1 and cross a bridge with blinking yellow lights. From there, keep driving east for about 2 kilometers and then you will come across another dirt road turns off with a gate on your right. Park here and it's a 4 kilometer walk to the wreckage. In case you are wondering, on November 24, 1973, this United States Navy Douglas Super DC-3 airplane crashed and was subsequently abandoned with no fatalities involved. Where the jumbos go to rest. Once the Boeing 747s and the McDonnell Douglas DC-10s ruled the skies. But now, the days of these sky giants are numbered because of their massive size, engine dependability and maintenance costs. The operating costs are too huge to be viable for today's competitive ticket pricing, and slowly but steadily, these planes are being decommissioned and retired. Ever wondered where these giants go to rest and be finally broken down for valuable parts and metal? Try the boneyard at the Southern California Logistics Airport. Here, the landscape is ever changing as old relics are broken down and carted off to make space for the never retirees. A treasure hunt in the middle of nowhere. We are back at Tucson, Arizona, home to the world's largest civilian aircraft boneyard named Pinell Air Park. This airplane-dusted acreage lies in the shadow of the Catalina Mountains and is actually 30 miles outside of Tucson. It's Arizona, so it is hot and dusty, and while this is a civilian space, there are plenty of menacing military carriers and personnel around. 1,200 acres of Arizona desert, littered with about 150 aircraft, is a big, big space to explore, especially if you are souvenir shopping. You cannot get in here uninvited, but if you are looking to buy something to decorate a space with, it's best to contact one of the aircraft carriers to get permission. The last salute of the high flyers. The F-4 Phantoms were a legend, entering into U.S. service in 1960 and staying put all the way till 1996, till they were finally pulled off and rested away to rest in peace. With so many successful missions, both domestically as well, in the service of many or other armies globally, the Phantom earned a whole troop of nicknames like Snoopy, Reno, Double Ugly, and Old Smokey. It was also called the Flying Anvil, Flying Footlocker, Flying Brick, the Big Iron Sled, and the San Luis Slugger. So this picture is like the Phantoms giving themselves a final salute, considering it was called the world's leading distributor of MIG parts. The mighty MIG no more. The MIGs went down like flies in front of the F-4 Phantoms, though they did hold their own admirably. Used primarily by the Soviet Union, Russia, and finally by India and Bulgaria. There are still enough MIGs in service, proving its long-lasting capability. This abject picture was taken at abandoned Motor Technica Museum in the German city and spa town of Bad Auenhausen. The image of a rusting MIG sitting on top of an equally decaying armored road vehicle is rather evocative of a past long gone by, and is probably the poster picture for the adage, how the mighty have fallen. Grounded Shark. The Longmaston Airfield was once the RAF Long Marston, a Royal Air Force station used for training in the Second World War, before it finally closed in 1954. Since then, it's housed a tiny aviation museum and hosted events and shows for the people around the area, till, in 2015, a housing project took over. The airstrip was demolished and all homes, businesses and establishments were forced to up and leave. Before it all went down, three airplanes were left languishing on the scene, one rather evocative. One was the Percival Sea Prince. Now, languishing where it once adorned the airfield entrance. The airport that once was a lifeline. When the Berlin Wall fell, there was cheering and rejoicing all around. Another casualty of German finally coming together as one country was West Berlin's Tempelhof Airport. It was officially closed in 2008 and then given over the public in 2010. Ever since then, people have come out to picnic at this prime piece of land that's bigger than Menorca, standing at some 303 hectares just waiting to be recommercialized. The Berlin people are having none of it and refuse to be sweet-talked into letting it turn back into an airport or redeveloped into something else. While most airplane companies upon and lift, a few abandoned aircraft still dot the place like a gentle threat that what once was could be the same again.